Thank you. Music from our own saxophonist, flautist, composer, arranger Nelson Rangel. His project is called Blue, and the tune you were listening to, Free as a Bird. And prior to that, in the middle of that set of three, you heard from three pretty good vocalists, George French, Jermaine Basil, and also the late Johnny Adams. They did a blues medley from their CD collectively called Mood Indigo. I hope you enjoy. Stay with us. Our Romantic Spotlight selection will feature Summer Romance.
Programming on KUVO is supported by the Denver Film Society, presenting the 38th Annual Denver Film Festival, November 4th through 15th, featuring over 250 films, red carpet presentations, special events, panels, and in-person guests. Festival lineup coming. Tickets and information at denverfilm.org/festival.
I'm Cynthia Hessen from iNews at Rocky Mountain PBS. This Friday night, look for guests who are in the know, thoughtful discussion, and original reporting on Colorado's state of mind. Our Friday night lineup starts with Washington Week at 7, then Colorado State of Mind, followed by Charlie Rose the Week, and later the McLaughlin Group. Rocky Mountain PBS is seen statewide on air and online at rmpbs.org. Join me this Friday and stay connected.
With this project called The Standard is Sonny Rollins. Here is his take on My One and Only Love.
Thank you.
tune is called My One and Only Love from the CD The Standard, Sonny Rollins. I hope you enjoy it. Once again, our forecast for this Thursday for the Vail area, sunny and mild. 64 for a high with a low tonight of 35 and 61, mostly sunny tomorrow. Right now, 58 in Vail and 60 in Breckenridge. Sunny and a bit windy later in the day for the metro area. 69 for a high with a low of 42. And we'll warm up to about 71 for tomorrow. Right now, 59 at City Park in Denver. You're tuned to KUVO Denver, KVJZ Vail, and 89.7 Breckenridge. Listen from anywhere at any time at KUVO.org. Lunchtime at the Oasis with Arturo Gomez comes your way next after NPR Headline News. Have a great Thursday as usual. Lend a hand today where you can.
From NPR News in Washington, I'm Luis Schiavone. President Obama says he has rethought a previous decision about U.S. troop levels in Afghanistan.
I've decided to maintain our current posture of 9,800 troops in Afghanistan through most of next year, 2016. Their mission will not change. Our troops will continue to pursue those two narrow tasks that I outlined earlier, training Afghan forces and going after al-Qaeda.
The president's original plan was to withdraw all but a small embassy-based U.S. presence by the end of 2016. Scottish prosecutors say they have identified and want to question two Libyan suspects over the Lockerbie bombing. NPR's Leila Fadel reports the prosecutors say the two were involved in the blast that killed 270 people in 1988. A spokesman for the Scottish Prosecution Office says the U.S. and Scottish authorities are requesting access to the men from the Libyan Attorney General. Scottish police and the FBI want to question the pair in Tripoli. The men are believed to have worked with Abdelbasit and Megrahi to carry out the attack. Megrahi was convicted of the 1988 blast that took down a Panam flight over Scotland that was bound for New York. The Scottish government released Megrahi in 2009 after he was diagnosed with prostate cancer. He died in 2012, still claiming he was innocent. Leila Fadel, NPR News. Astronomers have published new findings on the dwarf planet Pluto. As NPR's Jeff Brunfield reports, it appears that Pluto has more going on than previously thought.
Pluto is not dead. That's